Welcome to Toronto. So great to have you here.
Yeah, thank
and I
you
have
so
to
much.
Tell you, so wonderful in this movie. And I have to ask you, I mean, what is the secret or art to making the perfect paper plane?
I think it's in the crease. Okay, that's what we actually had the Australian world champions who came third in the world.
Wow.
On the film.
So this is a real thing.
This is
these people
a real
take
thing.
This very seriously.
Oh yeah. They don't look upon this as some kind of joke. No. They study aerodynamics, they study, you know, everything that flies pretty much. They practice, they have rehearsal spaces, they just, I bet their home is just, you can't see the floor.
Yeah.
It's probably just filled in paper planes. Which was, when I was filming it, my house was just, and my mum would go, hey, stop.
Enough already.
Yeah, we would recycle them, it's okay.
Good stuff.
Yeah, and we learned so many different paper planes. Round ones, triangle ones, ones that didn't fly. All kinds of ones.
That's really cool, though. That's a cool new skill to have, I think.
I think it is very cool. My friends always, then I don't really tell them, but, you know, I kind of go, I make this really cool, and they go, what? Which is a pretty cool skill to have.
Now, tell me about working with that cool dude, Sam Worthington. Really, like, a tough life, you know, not the nicest guy, you know, really. Well, how'd you guys bond? What was it like to work with? He's a great guy.
It was really fun.
Yeah.
It was great. We had a lot of fun. We just kind of messed around. We did a lot of improvising. We did a lot of just riffing and kind of physical. We just changed things, and it was great. And we changed it for the better. You know, sometimes we'd make it funnier.
Yeah.
Worse. Oops. And you know, more sad, more happy. Yeah. Just what we feel the scene needed.
Yeah.
So sometimes, yeah, we'd pick something up, say something, blah blah blah, do whatever it was. But and he told me a lot about that, and it was great working with him.
Yeah, yeah. Now, had you watched any of his films, like Avatar, even?
Who hasn't seen Avatar?
Who hasn't seen Avatar, exactly. Yeah, so.
Yeah.
But he's such a down-to-earth guy. Like, he's just, you know, you never know that he's in these huge films.
Yeah, you never know what they're like, but yeah. This guy.
Yeah, yeah. Well, we don't want to give him too big of a head, so yeah, we'll move on.
Yeah, we'll
What was it like, you know, just, you're starting to get recognized. People are soon going to get to really know you. Are you handling this fame okay? And how are your friends treating you?
You know what? Okay, so I have three friends. I'm not popular.
Oh, stop.
No, I'm not. At my school, they're not interested in acting, so they don't really understand, I don't think. So I don't really tell them. I just say, oh, I went and did something. And they go, oh, okay. You know, they don't really, oh, you know, what is it? And I just kind of go, man. And then I go, oh, I made a movie. And they go, oh, okay. So I am hoping to show them Paper Planes in Sydney, so they kind of get a little idea of what goes on behind the scenes.
Behind the scenes.
Yeah.
Okay, quickly, we need to talk about Alexander. I can never say this but without memorizing it. Because
it took me a while.
It's the longest
title. Have a go. Don't look at it.
Go for it. Oh, don't look. Alexander and the Terrible, Horrible, Bad Day?
No.
Did I miss something?
Mm-hmm.
I missed something. Go,
Alexander and the Terrible, Horrible, No Good, Very Bad Day.
There you go.
Mm-hmm.
Had you read the book? And
I had. It wasn't massive like it is here. Because when you say it anywhere, you know, Canada or the States, they go, oh, I love that book. I read it growing up. But you'll say it to Australian kids and they'll go, oh, okay, I know that book. We had it in our house. It wasn't a very, you know, I was never read it. Or, you know,
yeah.
Wasn't big, but I knew about it. I knew the story, I knew the concept.
But how cool, because Alexander in the book says that he wants to go off to Australia.
I know,
and here you get the role.
Hey. Yeah, it was crazy. The casting process was crazy. It was ridiculous. It was so long.
Yeah.
It was probably about 10 self-tapes. I went over to LA for 4 days, came back again, and my initial tape, the casting director said, oh, I have a look at this. And then the director went, no, we're not looking at anyone from Australia. So that could have been it, then and there. Could have just been. But
look at that. And having Steve Carell and Jennifer Garner as your parents.
Oh, my God.
What was it like to work with them?
They were the best. They were so nice. Jen is just the nicest, most caring mom. She's so, oh, my God, she's so lovely. And Steve, so cool. It was, oh, my, I can't explain it to you. I was brought up on Anchorman. That was, I can't even tell you the amount of time I've seen it. It still gets funny. I can quote the lines. At meeting him the first time, when he sat next to me for the table read, I was a bit, ooh, you're actually here, I'm here.
Yeah.
It was a bit exciting.
I can imagine. So what's been your most horrible, terrible, awful, awful day?
I haven't had really a substantial one like he has, but I've had my fair share of bad days when Oh, that didn't go well. Oh, that didn't go well. But never, you know, oh, the day before my birthday. Never that.
Well, you've done an extraordinary job in Paper
Thank
Planes.
You very
my
much.
Goodness, Ed. I can't wait to talk to you again for the next one. But just best of luck to you and have the best time while you're in Toronto. Try
Thank
and get some fun
much.
In, okay?
I'm hoping to do the CN
Tower.
Tower.
And if you're really brave, do the edge walk. You know, you can walk around
I
the edge.
I might call my mom when I'm up there.
Yeah, okay. Good to
Leave
talk to you, my
sky.
Friend.
Thank you.